Hello friends, today we are going to learn about the third chapter of statistics of 11th standard GSEB, and the name of the chapter is Measures of Central Tendency. In Measures of Central Tendency, we are going to cover up mean, median and mode. So in the first lecture, we are going to learn about arithmetic mean. It is denoted by x bar. Okay, so we are going to learn about the definition of the measures of central tendency. As this is the first topic that we are covering in the first lecture, and that is about mean, so let us have the definition of mean. Central tendency introduction. A central tendency refers to a central value or a representative value of a statistical series. And according to Clark, it has been said, an average is a figure that represents the whole group. So for example, if we are talking about a career of a cricketer, say for example, Sachin's average. So Sachin's average in test is somewhere around 50. So what does that indicate? It indicates an average, that is, he is not scoring 50 runs in every innings. But what is there? Whatever the total number of runs are scored by him divided by the number of matches played by him. So you get an average of it. And that is termed as mean. I explained a simple example of mean. Let us now understand the definition of mean. So arithmetic mean. The definition of arithmetic mean: the sum of the values of all observations divided by the number of observations. The same example we had before, that is Sachin's average. So the number of runs scored by Sachin, that will be added up, and that will be divided by the number of innings he has played, and that gives the average. So arithmetic mean, that is the sum of the values of all observations divided by the number of observations. It is known as mean or average, and as I said, it is denoted by x bar. We are going to start with the sums of the same of the arithmetic mean. So coming on to the practical examples of arithmetic mean. So talking about the methods of arithmetic mean, we are familiar with the methods: direct method, shortcut method and step deviation method that we had already learned in our 10th standard statistics chapter. So we are going to revise the same methods: direct method, shortcut method and step deviation method. So let us start with the direct method. What exactly we mean by the direct method, how to solve the sum of it. So coming on to the direct method, now to make it easier, just follow the steps what I say. And I have divided the sum of mean into three types: type 1, type 2 and type 3. Now what exactly I do mean by type 1, type 2 and type 3? So let's start with the sums. So the first type what I have written is, if only xi is given, that is termed as discrete frequency or the raw data, right? Discrete frequency or the raw data. So the simple formula for finding out the mean when only xi is given, the formula is summation of xi upon n. You can call it summation of xi or sigma xi. So summation of xi divided by n gives you the answer for the arithmetic mean of that question. So that is type 1.
So the first sum is of the first method, in which only xi is given. So as I explained, x bar is equal to summation of xi divided by n. So just write down all this and add it up. So what you are going to do is 47 plus 53 plus 52 plus and so on divided by the number of observations. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9 and 10. So when you add all this, whatever number you are going to get Over here we are going to get 749 divided by 10, and that answer turns out to be 74.9. That is your answer for x bar. So that is the first method where only xi is given. What are you going to do? You are going to add up, that is summation of xi divided by n, and you get the answer for your mean type 1, only xi given. Thank you.
So we are going to go for the type 2 sums, in which you will be given with the xi and fi. So if you are given with xi and fi, what you are supposed to do? There are two methods to solve the sum. So over here, first of all, I am going for the direct method. So direct method, the formula is x bar is equal to summation of fi xi divided by n. N is nothing but summation of the frequency given, that is summation of fi. The formula is x bar is equal to summation of fi xi divided by n. So whenever you are given with xi and fi, first of all multiply the fi xi, you get the summation of fi xi, get the total of fi, you get the summation of fi, that is n, and apply the formula. So for the second method, that is when you are given with xi and fi, and we are talking about the shortcut method, so the two things we need to remember. First is convert the xi into di. To convert xi into di, di is equal to xi minus a, or di is equal to xi minus a upon c. And fi into di is the column to be prepared, to be multiplied, that is di and fi. So formula is x bar is equal to a plus summation of fi di upon n, or x bar is equal to a plus summation of fi di upon n multiplied by c.
So the second type of the sum that will be given is xi and fi. So in the sum, you can see as I have written xi and fi. So you will be given with the question xi and frequency of it fi. So this can be solved using two methods, the direct method and the shortcut method. Now, first of all, I am going for the direct method. So the first step in the direct method is we are going to multiply xi and fi. Multiply fi xi. So the given frequency multiplied by xi. So 10 into 3 comes to 30. 20 into 4, 18. 30 into 5, 150. 40 into 2, 18. And 50 into 1, 50. So have the total of fi xi and have the total of fi. So the formula, I am explaining the direct method, x bar is equal to summation of fi xi divided by summation of fi, also written as n. So have the total of it, whatever the total comes. So 50 plus 150 is 200, 280, 360 and 390. Divide by 5, 4, 3, 2, 1, it comes to 15. So 390 divide by 15, you get the answer, and that is the answer of x bar. So this is a direct method in which you can find out the answer of mean, that is simply multiply the fi and xi. So you get the column of fi xi, get the total of that, and that is termed as the summation of fi xi, and this is the summation of frequency, that is summation of fi, also known as n. Have the formula, summation of fi xi divided by summation of fi divided by, that is the n, and you get the answer for the mean. Now how to go for the shortcut method? You have learned about it, and shortcut method hum yahan pe jo padhne wale. In that, we have to remember, to make it easier, we just need to have a column of di, and di is equal to xi minus a upon c. Now the simple thing, di is equal to xi minus a, a is an assumed number, a is an assumed number. So you need to assume one number from the given xi. Now my trick is, find out the highest and the lowest number from here, that is highest is 50 and the lowest is 10, and have a number assumed in between that. So over here in between we are having 30, so So let's assume A as 30 and C, meaning thereby we need to have a common divisibility. So common divisibility over here is 10. So you can go for 0, where it is a common divisibility, minus 1, you are going to be at minus 2, 1 and 2. You can check it out. Xi minus A, so 10 minus 30, minus 20, minus 20 divided by 10, it comes to minus 2. 20 minus 30, it comes to minus 10, minus 10 divided by 10, it comes to minus 1. So that's the way to find out the di. The next step is multiply fi into di. That is the frequency to be multiplied with the di that we have converted. So 3 into minus 2 is minus 6, 4 into minus 1 is minus 4, 5 into 0 is 0, 2 into 1 is 2, and 1 into 2 is 2. Get the total of it. So getting the total, 2 plus 2 4, 4 minus 4 0, so we are getting the total as minus 6. Now when we are talking about the shortcut method, the formula for that is x bar is equal to a plus summation of fi di upon n multiplied by c. Replace the values. What you have assumed as a, you have assumed as 30. Summation of fi di, that comes to minus 6, divided by fi, that is 15, and multiplied by 10. Always remember, first of all, try to solve this part. Whatever your answer is, and do remember, whether you solve it by the shortcut method or you solve it by the direct method, the answer for the x bar would be same. तो आप क्रॉस चेक कर सकते हो कि दोनों में से आपको कौन सा इजी लगता है, दोनों के आंसर सेम आने चाहिए. अनलेस एंड अंटिल इन द क्वेश्चन, इन द क्वेश्चन पेपर इट इज मेंशन सॉल्व बाय दिस मेथड, इट्स योर चॉइस टू सॉल्व इट बाय एनी ऑफ द मेथड दैट इज इजियर टू यू. सो यू कैन गो फॉर द शॉर्टकट मेथड और यू कैन गो फॉर द डायरेक्ट मेथड, व्हिच एवर इज इजियर. ओके, सो दैट वाज द सेकंड टॉपिक, दैट इज समेशन ऑफ fi di एंड fi xi. Second type, type 2, xi, fi given. Third type we will be coming up with, and that will be the class and fi. So that was the second method. Okay.
For the type 3, when class and fi is given, the first step is find out the mid value of the given class. The mid value of the given class will be taken as xi. After finding out the xi, you can go for two methods. Direct method and the shortcut method. Direct method, multiply fi xi and apply the formula, that is x bar is equal to summation of fi xi divided by n. Or else you can go for di is equal to xi minus a upon c. Multiply fi di, use the formula x bar is equal to a plus summation of fi di upon n multiplied by c.
That is type 3, when class and fi is given. So we have learned about the two types. First of all, type 1, only xi given. Type 2, xi and fi given. Now we are going to start with the type 3, and that is your class and fi given. So there are again two methods to solve this sum. As I have explained, direct method and the shortcut method. So first of all, going for the direct method. So how to solve this sum by the direct method when you are given with the class and fi? So first thing is, you will find out the mid value. Mid value is denoted by xi. Now how to find out the mid value? You are given with the first class as 10 to 20. So 10 plus 20 is 30, and 30 divided by 2, that comes to 50. That is the first step, 50. Now see to it that when you are given with a class, and if the class length is the same, I am saying class length is the same, then mid value, the difference in the mid value would be same. So if you observe over here, there is a class length of 10. So if the first mid value is 15, the second mid value would be add 10 to it, and it is 25. 45, and 15 5. That is where you get the mid value known as xi. So you get the value of xi as the mid value. After the mid value is obtained, for the direct method you need to multiply fi and xi. So the frequency to be multiplied with the mid value xi, and whatever the answer is, that is summation of fi xi. I'm just going to explain with the methods, and you can solve the sum accordingly. So the first method, that is direct method, and that is a class and fi given. Multiply fi xi, so 4 into 15 is 60, 25 into 5 125, and whatever you are getting, just add it up, you get the total of summation of fi xi. Get the total of summation of fi and have the formula x bar is equal to summation of fi xi divided by n. That is the total of summation of fi. So you get the answer by the direct method for the type 3 when class and fi is given, right? So we are going to learn about the shortcut method of the same, by the way to convert xi into di. जो xi है उसको हम di में convert करेंगे, जैसे हमने type 2 में सीखा था. So convert that xi into di, and then the formula remains the same for the shortcut method. Let's solve that also. So the shortcut method, convert di xi into di. Di is equal to xi minus a upon c. Convert the xi into di. As I explained, I can assume any number. I am assuming 35 as a, that is an assumed number. As the class length is same, again I am saying class length agar same hai tabhi aap ye shortcut ke andar ye ek shortcut kar sakte ho ki 0 ke baad directly minus 1, minus 2, 1 and 2. Never is the sum just that what you solved for the type 2 question, xi fi given, it will be similar. Go for fi di column, fi into di. So 4 into minus 2 is minus 8, 5 into minus 1 is minus 5, 3 into 0 is 0, 1 into 1 is 1, and 2 into 2 is 4. Have the total of it. Go for the formula. This is the summation of fi di. So x bar is equal to a plus summation of fi di upon n multiplied by c. Replace the values of it, where in a is equal to 35, you will get the total of fi di. You need to replace that fi, that is the total of this, that comes to 15, and then multiplied by the class length, that is 10, and you get the answer for the same using your calculators. That is the answer for x bar. So till now we have learned about the three methods. Type 1, only xi given. Type 2, xi and fi given. Type 3, class and fi given. By both the methods, direct method as well as shortcut method. I hope your questions will be easy to solve using these methods, and I hope you get the answers correct. Right? Coming up with more lectures, more interesting tricks, stay tuned. And do like, share and subscribe for the YouTube channel. Thank you.